Hey guys, JBRider here. Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to Crossout. Hope you guys are doing well. Today I am doing my very first list video. I'm doing a top 12 video. Doing a top 12 weapons that are worth crafting during the Ravenspath event. We got 16 days left and I'm not gonna cover all of them, or I might cover most of them just quickly, but the 12 that are really worth it, I'm gonna cover like extensively. So as you guys can see, I already got some arbiters lined up here. So the first weapon that I think is worth crafting is the MG14 arbiter, because if you take a look at the upgrades, we got 10% more durability, we got time to overheating plus 10% as well, and we got weapon spread negative 17%. So those are the best combos you could get for the fused arbiters. Now I got some fused arbiters on this build right here, and I'm gonna quickly check it out. All right, now as you guys saw there in the side-by-side comparison, the reduction in spread does help out quite a lot. It's not like super amazing, but you know, negative 70% is pretty noticeable, and I think it might come in handy in like clan wars situation. I've already faced them in clan wars and they're pretty good, like fused arbiters, four fused arbiters, pretty deadly, man. The next weapon that I think is worth fusing is the pyres. Now I haven't tested yet if the pyres work, the fused pyres work with the dust cabin, because the dust cabin basically overrides the pyres stats in terms of damage and accuracy or turning angle. So we're gonna check that out as well. But the pyre itself is a pretty good fusion. Durability 10%, that is good, because look at the durability, only 57 with a fused pyre, so that is pretty good. Reload time negative 9%, rocket turn speed plus 15%, so they become more accurate. So we're going to do a quick test with and without the dust cabin and see how both perform. All right, now as you guys saw, the pyre perk actually works with the dust cabin. So those missile builds are gonna be super happy to get that fusion. I personally got this fusion as well because I thought, you know, fast reloading pyres are just super awesome. So we got the arbiter out of the way, we got the pyre out of the way. The next fusion that is really worth it is this freaking breaker. Now, breakers are right now meta in clan wars, and they got even better. Like, look at these modifications. 10% extra durability, time to overheating 10% as well, and weapon spread negative 17%. Now that is crazy, man. That is really good. Now I'm gonna check this out for you guys as well. All right, the left breaker is a fused one and the right breaker is a stock one. Oh wow, yeah, look at that spread. It's in such a nice, oh, that one's kind of, well, did you see that? Okay, wait. Maybe if I fire too fast. Nope, that one's pretty big. Jesus Christ, that spread is pretty insane. That's a default one. It has more closely it has less spread for like a few shots, but then there's like this random shot that is like super spread out. See? Yeah, this one has like all of them are like spread out, the default one, but the fused one. Let me just quickly check on a build right here. Oh yeah, it's way more accurate. That's nice. Yeah, no, I like them, dude. I like them a lot. So that is a very good fusion to get like extra durability. They're already so strong, 426 fused, and default is 387. Yeah, a very good fusion to get. So the next weapon that is really worth fusing is the vectors. I'm gonna definitely craft some vectors because you get 10% extra durability, time to overheating 10% longer, and a spread growth when firing decreased by 17%. Also a very, very good fusion. I'm gonna check it out real quick and show you guys the difference. Right, as you guys can see, again, not a super big difference, but if you're gonna tap fire, the extra reduction in spread will definitely help out. Like, especially those skilled hover players that play at low power score with these things, they are gonna strip your weapons off super duper quick. Let's move on to the next weapon. At number 5, we have the Hot Red Engine. I've been waiting to get this fusion for a very long time, and it pretty much has the good perks. It has 10% extra durability and bonus to power 10% as well. Not much I can show you for this one. It just, you know, it's pretty self-explanatory, but definitely good. I can show you the upgrades you can get with it. We'll just quickly go to the Lunatics. Oh no, I need to go to my actual garage. So the upgrade options are bonus to power 10%, bonus to speed 10%. I don't think this one's really worth it. Weight limit is pretty garbage. Resistance to all damage is also pretty good. Actually, all these are pretty good except for mass because it's not a super heavy engine. But yeah, durability, the one you got in the crafting event is pretty good. Extra durability. So I would definitely get this one as well. Personally, I'm getting this one as well. Now, let's move on to number 6. At number 6, we have the Cohort Fusion. The Cohort Fusion is the God Fusion, giving you less mass because it's a pretty heavy cabin at 4,000 something kilograms. Delay before self-destruction is, you know, nothing that special, but weight limit 10%, which gives you the heaviest carrying vehicle or cabin in the game. This is the best fusion you can get for the Cohort. Unfortunately, pretty expensive for legendary cabins are pretty expensive right now, so unfortunately I cannot get this, but for those of you who can, this is a really, really good fusion. Let's check out the other fusion option for the Cohort real quick. We got extra durability 10%, 70% less mass, which is what the one we got, resistance to all damage plus 10%, and the second one's power is not that great, delay before self-destruct, self-destruct explosion radius, and self-destruction damage. I don't mind any of these, but weight limit is pretty good. Power might come in handy with the new torque changes that the developers have planned, so power might become a useful option in the future. At number 7, we have the Cyclone Fusion. Now, cyclones are a bit underrated. Personally, I don't like using autocannons, but they are powerful. They are really powerful. And you get also pretty awesome combo fusion for this one as well. You get 10% durability. Durability for weapons is always good because weapons get stripped off pretty easy. Time to overheat is pretty good because it's a weapon that overheats. And spread is also pretty good because this thing is an automatic firing weapon. So you get pretty much the most awesome fusion settings for the cycle. But again, pretty expensive since it's a legendary weapon. Now, at number 8, we have one of the most hated weapons or modules, whatever you want to call it. The cap can mine layer just got even more powerful. It has negative 70% mass, which is helpful for beefy builds. We got negative 9% reload rate, and we got a projectile range of plus 15%. So now capcans will snag you even further away, which is gonna be pretty freaking annoying. But luckily, capcans are super expensive, so I don't think a lot of people are gonna go for these. I mean, if you can do it, your cabin, it's more expensive than a legendary cabin right now, because right now on the market, the capcan is going for 4,000 coins, I believe. Let's quickly, yep. Yeah, it's above 4,000 now, like 4,100 coins right now. So yeah, pretty expensive fusion if you're gonna go for these. Next up at number 9, we have another god fusion, and it is for the Skinner Harpoon. The Skinner Harpoon gives you 10% more durability, negative 9% reload, and an extra range of 15%. So now you can snag people at longer distance. I'm personally also getting this one, because skinning people is just, or using the skinner on people is just a lot of fun. You can snag a lot of people, and it might save you as well, as you guys saw in one of my other videos.
Yep, definitely selling these. Oh, you son of a... Hey, yeah, come here, dude. Come here.
Next up at number 10, we have the Chameleon Mark 1. Now, the Chameleon Mark 1 isn't super great, but for lower power scores it is pretty handy, because now you get negative 17% reload time and 10% extra durability. So for the lower power score build, it can be very, very handy. Next up, at number 11, we have the Spark 3 Tesla, or Tesla Emitter. This is another god fusion, because you get 10% extra durability, you get time to overheating plus 10%, and a firing range plus 15%. So sparks are gonna be so good. Like, unfortunately, again, super expensive, and I cannot afford to use two sparks to get one fuse sparks. And if you want three sparks, that's like six sparks you need to buy, and yeah, it's just it hurts thinking about the price. Hey guys, post production JB here. So as I was testing these sparks, for some reason, if you angle the weapon, it hits the target further. So that was kind of strange. And the maximum range isn't that much, but still a big difference, especially if you like angle the weapon. So I'm not sure what that is all about. Next up at number 12, we have another god fusion. Well, not god fusion, but it's a pretty good fusion. The Aegis Prime. Now, the Aegis Prime gives you negative 17% reload time. That is really, really helpful for the Aegis. The negative 17% mass isn't that great, because as you guys can see, it's a pretty light module. I would much rather have like 10% durability to make it a little bit stronger, but I mean, Aegis Primes are usually hidden in the center of the build, so it's not easily shot off, so that's why it doesn't really matter. The most important thing is the negative 70% in reload rate. All right, so that is it for the 12 best fusions of this event. Now I'm going to quickly cover the ones I did not mention in this list. Not that they're bad, but I just personally don't think it's worth going for them. Now, first off, we have the Beholder. Actually, Beholder is also pretty good because you get extra mass limit. Everybody likes that. But the Beholder is mostly used, well, the meta used builders use it on hovers. And the one we get with the Battle Pass is already pretty good. That one is fused for tonnage, which is pretty good on hover. So people, you know, people that got it with the Battle Pass, it's already good fusion, so it's not really worth fusing it. If you did not get it in the Battle Pass, fusing it to get this is, yeah, actually worth it in my opinion then. Next up, APC wheels. Wheels are kind of pointless to me, unless it was like the Icarus 7 hover. The Iron Seal fusion is okay. I would much rather have 10% extra durability instead of the negative 17% mass. You can honestly wait for the fusion events where it's 50% off, so you only need one radiator instead of two. So I just would wait for this one. For the Iron Seal and the Shiver, I would just wait to get the special fusion event going on. The AC-42 Reaper, not that great. Recoil is, eh, time to overheat is pretty good, but I still don't think it's really worth it. The AC-43 Reaper has a fusion where it reduces the spread. I would much rather have that. The R2 Chill, pretty good in my opinion. If you're playing at low bar score, it is a good fusion, but it's, you know, it's pretty cheap to get. The Hulk ZS-33 projectile speed is pretty good. Reload time is okay. I would much rather have like extra damage or explosion radius, so that's why I'm not getting this one. The ammo pack is pretty good as well. Extra durability, module efficiency 56% is very good, but I don't like these because they pop so fast, so I don't even run them on my build. The Mastodons, a lot of people want these and I want them too, but the Mastodons, their fusion is not that great. The reload time perk is really good, but the projectile speed, it's okay. The projectile speed is okay if you're used to it, but the negative 17% mass is kind of a waste. I would much rather have 10% extra durability, because 10% of 1500 durability is quite a lot. But the negative 17 mass, I mean, this thing is already heavy, so having less mass is basically pointless unless you're trying to run the lightest Mastodon build out there. So yeah, it's a good fusion, but super duper expensive. And if you do one and you have one fused Mastodon and one stock Mastodon, you're just gonna mess up your firing accuracy, because one's gonna fire faster with the projectile speed and reload, and one is gonna fire very weird. So yeah, now these are the stock things you can craft. Not gonna cover these because you pretty much know that already. The Colossus is unfortunately a very bad fusion. It has no extra power, the 10% power. The negative 17% in mass is a waste. I would much rather have durability. And the weight limit, negative plus 3%, is pretty much ignorable because it's pretty garbage. The Nova Cabin, negative 17% mass. Again, I would much rather have durability. Cabin tonnage is good if you run it on hovers, but it's already good on hovers, so don't really need it. But it's a pretty meta cabin, so I think those people that really run it a lot, it could be a good fusion for them as well. But I would much rather have their ability there instead. Camber steering wheels, again, I don't see the point in fusing wheels. The little boys, I personally have the perfect little boy fusion with extra durability, reload time, and explosive radius. So I like that one instead of this one. Projectile speed is cool and all, but it doesn't really do anything. Like, you know, I mean, it's already a slow firing shell, so projectile speed doesn't really help it out a lot. I would much rather have damage or explosion radius. The harvester gives you a 10% extra durability and 5% extra melee damage. I think the 5% is pretty much nothing. Like, if it was 10% extra damage, I think it would be worth it. But yeah, it's a good fusion, but personally, I would not go for this either. Next up, we have the Growl Cabin, negative 17% mass, extra weight limit, and self-destruct fusion.
I took A for the weight limit. You know, if you want extra weight limit, run low bar score builds. Again, I would much rather have durability than negative mass because it's a light cabin. Like, the only reason you want to have negative mass if you're running like those super heavy cabins, because those are super heavy, like 4,500 kilos. So, you know, if you get then the negative mass, it will kind of help out there. But yeah, next up we have the Shiver. Again, the Shiver. Just wait for the 50% off fusion event, just where you can just use one shiver, because you'll always get the cooling efficiency perk no matter what you do. It's just the other perk is gonna change. Twin wheel, again, a wheel, don't really like it. Unguided rockets, those wasps, the wasp fusion for reload is pretty good. Projectile speed and durability is pretty good, but I have the ones with extra explosion radius, so I like those one better than projectile speed. But projectile speed could work. It could work, but I'd much rather have the explosion radius, because I run it with the Harpy cabin, it just makes it extra exciting. The Icarus 4 is the hover nobody uses, so yeah, it's pretty much not a good fusion because no one uses these anymore. Sledgehammer fusion is actually pretty good. Durability 10%, time to overheating 10% extra, and the spread is negative 17%. It's actually a really good fusion. I think I overlooked it to put it on my list because yeah, I don't think I was gonna go for it. It didn't really get me excited, you know, so that's why I didn't put it on the list. But the fusion is really good, top notch. Durability, time to overheat, and spread, actually all the things you want and in a shotgun. Next up, another wheel, don't cover these. Tamir, the Tamir cooler, also a pretty good fusion. Cooling efficiency 21% extra, durability 10%, also really good fusion. If you're running low bar score builds, this is it's not a bad fusion. It's also pretty cheap to do. Judge is pretty much the same story as the little boy. I would much rather have like explosion radius and damage instead of projectile speed. And the negative mass is kind of okay because they're pretty heavy, but durability would always be better for cannons for me than negative or less mass. Same thing goes for the elephant. It has the same, it's the same story. Like, I would much rather have different perks, and that's pretty much it. This video is kind of weird and different for me, so feedback in the comment section so I can make it better and more enjoyable to watch for you guys. But that's basically it. I think it's gonna be a long one. Hope you guys enjoyed. I'll see you guys in the next one, and let me know which fusions you are going for. I already mentioned mine, so I want to know yours. And if you guys have different opinions on what I said, I'll leave them in the comment section as well, because I would like to read, because it will make me smarter about Crossout stuff. Also, what's funny, the cabin is so small compared to these tracks. Like, these tracks are like something of a leopard or something, and the cabin is supposed to be like a tank cabin, but it's so small. I hope we get like cool, awesome, some kind of tank cabin, which is slope. Anyways, have a great day. Peace out.